feet that walk upon the sacred earth. Blessed is my vision, illumined by the sun and the moon. Blessed are my hands that prepare the sacred temple. May the gods be with me forever. Suffering and affliction are part of life, yet when we separate the grain from the chaff, we find the happiness that remains. Sun is the light of life and the light of the spirit and the light of the flame. Behold the light of the sun. Radiant sun, the nights are long, and thy cooling flames and fading light promise even longer nights. In spring, thy spark of life had blessed thy son, the green lord Viridius, and gifted him with health and strength as he flourished in the fields and orchards, even at the time of the harvests. But now thou fallest in thy path in the heavens, and the land grows cold. O Mother Earth, thou hadst nurtured thy son Viridius when days were long, but now is the time of his fall, and now is the time of thy grieving, as his life force slips away in the autumn leaves that sink through the cold portal of death and drapes him in a tarnished shroud of yellow, auburn, russet, crimson and gold. Praise be to thee, O blessed mother, for thy fallen child is enfolded in thy loving embrace, even when sorrow has made thee cold. Ye desolate winds, your sad elegies whisper forlornly through his tarnished shroud. Ye mournful rains, your tears of sorrow mingle with his leaves. God, O ye winds and rains. When lamenting is over and tears are dry, ye take comfort, knowing that his shroud of many colours becomes his fresh green mantle as the great wheel turns. O greatest mother, thou art always with me. Thou hast been with me from the beginning. I shall be with thee at life's end. Tonight I remember friends and loved ones who are now enfolded in thy loving embrace. All my friends, relatives. Lord, God and Father's Lord. Almighty Kernos, great Lord of the Animal Kingdom, thou who watchest over all our lives, let me ever remember that death is not an ordeal, for it is swift and painless, but it is pain and sorrow and the confrontation of death that are the ordeals. So when it is time for our spark of life to be extinguished, we who suffer need not fear the compassionate grace. Ye mighty ones, through thy grace all things must pass. By the strength of the sun, by the phases of the moon, the devotion of the earth, the changes wrought by the winds and the rains. May I undergo the mysteries of sorrow with courage and fortitude, henceforth to find peace within. May your blessings be upon me now and forever. So must it be. Sacrifice, the Green Lord makes me whole. He dies that I may live. His blessings strengthen my body, encourage my heart, and uplift my spirit. I bless and consecrate this sacred bread and the boundless love of the Great Mother and the limitless light of the Great Father. I behold the body of Viridius. And consecrate this sacred wine in the boundless love of the Great Mother and the limitless light of the Great Father. I behold the spirit of Viridius. Bountiful Mother and glorious Father, receive my humble thanks for your blessings which I am about to receive through the body and spirit of Viridius. Green Lord sustains my body. Green Lord fortifies my spirit. Thou sacred bread of the golden grain, thou sacred wine of the purple grapes, receive my humble thanks, for through thee I am filled with the light of the sun, wholeness of the earth. The energy of the winds and the powers of water. Through thee, blessed Green Lord, they abide within me, and I am one with them as thou art one with me. So must it be. O glorious Son, beloved Mother Earth, silver moon, invisible winds, sparkling rains. I thank thee for blessing me with life. There is no part of me that is not of you. I affirm the significance of all that exists. For ye are my guardians, my guides, and my gods, now and forever. So must it be.